Good morning. What a wonderful day to be able to praise the Lord. What a wonderful day to be able to rise and to know that the Lord has blessed us with such a wonderful and blessed, blessed new day. A day of new opportunities, a day of knowing that God goes before us and will be with us. I hope you are all well. And just a privilege to be with you this morning, just to worship and to share with you. And I just trust that you're all well and that the Lord has been blessing you and keeping you safe. Let us begin this time in prayer. Let us pray. Wonderful Father, we thank you that as we come into this new day, that we can know that, Father, you go before us. That, Father, you have blessed us through the night, that you have kept us safe. And that as we go into this day, that, Father God, we need to doubt nothing and know that you are with us. In every step we take, in every decision we need to make, in everything we need to do, that you go before us. And in that, Lord, we trust. And in that, we just know that and have this expectant heart that all will be well, knowing that you are with us. Father, we ask you to be with us now as we share together and as we hear your word. We pray and we ask this in your mighty name. Amen. Our reading this morning is taken from Hebrews 11, verses 8 to 19. Hebrews 11 verses 8 to 19, and it reads as follows. By faith, Abram, when called to go to the place he would later receive as his inheritance, obeyed and went, even though he did not know where he was going. And by faith, he made his home in the promised land like a stranger in a foreign country. He lived in tents, as did Isaac and Jacob, who were heirs with him of the same promise, for he was looking forward to the city with foundations, whose architect and builder is God. By faith, Abraham, even though he was past age, and Sarah herself was barren, was enabled to become a father, because he considered him faithful who had made the promise. Thanks be to God for his word. I would like to make a statement this morning and say that the believer looks forward to the future. His faith in God leads him to expect blessings even in the most forbidding circumstances. Abram illustrates this as we read in verses 17 and 19, where Abram visualized Isaac, his God-given son, as his successor and the father of God's people. This expectancy satisfied him deeply. But now God tried him. He told him to offer up Isaac. And Abram in his mind now saw his God given son dead. God had to be obeyed. But Abram's mind didn't rest there. He remembered God's promise about Isaac, and he knew, therefore, that Isaac must live. How could Isaac's death and continued life be reconciled? Abram resolved it by expecting God to raise Isaac from the dead. His faith in God assured him that God wouldn't break his word. One cannot separate faith in God from expectancy. The God who cares for us, plans for us. No matter how dark the night, there is a glorious day ahead. Every morning when we awake, let us look forward to the coming day. No matter how many difficulties we foresee, God is with you. If God is for us, who can be against us? You can trust him implicitly. Know that if you walk with him obediently in faith, your day is going to be a good one. And maybe, just maybe, there will be a surprise package of blessing which you hadn't anticipated. And this often happens when we walk with the Lord. Every new day is a brand new opportunity. God has a worthwhile plan for it, and he has for your whole life, for your whole eternity. Lift up that drooping heart. Be a believer. Be a believer in the future. Amen. Let us pray. Lord, I look forward to this day that you have given me. I know that I have a part to play in your great kingdom. Keep me alert to what you are doing and my part in it, and may I serve you with all my heart. And may I look to the future knowing that you are in control. Amen. Have a truly blessed and wonderful day, and God bless you all. Bye.